So tell me if you're really there. Don't make me fall in love again if you won't be here next year. Santa, tell me if you really cares, 'cause I can't give it all away if you won't be here next year. Feeling Christmas all around and trying to play it cool, but it's hard to focus when I see him walking across the room. Let it snow, it's faster now, but I won't get in the mood. I'm avoiding every mistletoe until I know it's true. Now that he is alone, so next Christmas I'm not all alone, boy. Tell me if you're
Vlogmas. I love watching Vlogmas as a viewer, so I'm so excited to participate in my very first Vlogmas. Look, I don't really be doing a lot, so we really gonna see how this gonna go. So it's Sunday, December 1st. It is about 35 degrees in Atlanta. I don't know who told Atlanta to be this cold, but I'm gonna need that person to like chill out. Cause it don't make no goddamn sense. Like, are we even in winter? Is it even winter season yet? Hey Siri! When does winter season start?
Sorry, I don't know when that is.
Hey Siri, when does winter season start?
Sorry, I don't know when that is.
What? Is that a weird question? Am I asking it weird? When does winter season start? December 21st to March 20th. So it's not even winter yet. Is it? Whatever, Siri. Siri. As much updates that Apple does, they have like this AI intelligence shit and the cameras they keep trying to fix and stuff like that. You would think that Siri would be far more advanced than what she is. Like, I should be able to talk to Siri like a regular person. We should be able to have a whole conversation, and she should be able to pick up on it and, you know, act accordingly. I just don't understand. Anyways, we won't talk about that. It's Vlogmas. It's December 1st. It's cold outside. Today, I'm going to go run some errands. So we're going to go to the grocery store. I'm going to go to the farmer's market, Publix, and Walmart. If you don't go to multiple grocery stores, are you okay? Let's see, what else do I have to do? Then I have to, I'm just gonna do some more like Christmas shopping type stuff, like online. I'm gonna try to find, I did a lot of Christmas shopping on Black Friday. Like that day, y'all, when they come, okay. I got some Tom Ford Locket, I think they're called Locket Heels, dupes, on super duper duper sale. Like, they're not the Tom Ford heels, they're the dupes, so they look like it, except minus the lock. Same everything, minus the lock and a big Tom Ford. But they're from a brand that's a nice brand, high quality brand. And I got them for like a steal, like 50, 65, 70, like 85% off. Not even lying. So, when those like come in, I don't know like if I'm gonna open the gifts as they come in or if I'm gonna wrap them for myself and put them underneath the Christmas tree. I'm leaning towards wrapping them and putting them underneath the Christmas tree, but I kinda wanna freaking show these to people because they still have like a bunch left. My battery's about to die. They still have a bunch left and it's a really good sale. I don't know, we'll see. Anyways, so I'm gonna go to the grocery store. I can't film in the farmer's market I cannot film in the farmer's market, and that's where I do the bulk of my grocery shopping. So I'm gonna just meet you guys when I get back home. Plus, it's Saturday. It's the Sunday after Thanksgiving. So I'm hoping it's not crazy busy, but it's usually always busy. But whatever, we'll touch bases when I get back, and I will show you all the groceries that I get. It's Vlogmas! So excited. Oh, and if you're watching this video and you don't know what Vlogmas is, where have you been? Thanks for being here, but where have you been? Vlogmas is pretty much where I'm going to vlog every day up until Christmas, December 25th, and post it, like daily vlogs, all the way up until Christmas. So, this is gonna be a challenge because I'm a slow editor. I'm not a slow editor when, you know, for my other stuff, like my UGC stuff, I'd be on that shit quick. But like, it'd be a lot. So with YouTube, the long form content, yeah, I'm a slow editor on. But that's okay. Cause we gonna get it. We gonna get it. Anyways, my battery about to die. I'm gonna tap in when I get back from the grocery store. We back. Ciao. You know, I was like, oh, going to the grocery store the Sunday after Thanksgiving is crazy, right? Like, girl, ain't gonna be nothing up in the store. But then I was like, I don't buy a lot of pre-packaged foods. I don't buy a lot of already ready to made meals and things like that. Like, I don't do that. So I felt like the grocery stores was gonna have enough of what I freaking buy. Whole Foods, essentially. I just got this, my bag from the farmer's market. Okay, this my bag from the farmer's market, child. I just got about two of these. Okay. Did not go to Walmart. I mean, we did not go to Publix because their buy one get ones were just, don't got nothing I need that's on a BOGO, so I ain't gonna worry about it. We did go to Walmart. This little bag I got at Walmart. That's it. So let me show you what I got. Let's start with Walmart. Oh, Lord, my back. This was not on the list, but I got the All's Well Savor candles. Y'all seen these candles in Wally World before. This is the coconut wax blend candle. And it's pistachio, marshmallow, sea salt. And I see the color. I always go down the aisle just to see if they have any candles on sale or anything like that. Just to like look. But then I see the color and I was like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. That's why you shouldn't go down aisles and try to look for sales and stuff. You should just get what's on your list. Cause now look, $13. Anyways, so I was like, oh my gosh, does this smell like the pistachio fragrance from Kaylee? Does this smell like the pistachio fragrance from Zara? No, but it does come very, very close. It's more marshmallowy than pistachio-y. The Zara and Kaylee fragrances are more pistachio-y. But this smells really good. I was like, oh my gosh, this smells really good. And I love the color. Even though it's not a wintry color, it's a summer, summer even color. So I don't know if I'm gonna burn it now. I might, cause it's cute. It kind of goes with my room. Anyway, child, we ain't talking about this damn. Let's get into the haul. I got me some condensed milk. It's just milk, sugar. It's just literally milk and sugar. So I buy condensed milk. I'll make my own homemade coffee creamer with this. Or sometimes I like to put this with jasmine tea or green tea. I think my grandmother gave it to us with green tea. When we were growing up, like, she would make breakfast for us. She would give us like a tea and condensed milk as a sweetener and milk. I think it was a green tea, or maybe it was a black tea, I don't know, but I just love it. So sometimes, you know, I be getting to my feelings or whatever, and I want to eat, want to drink how my grandmama made it for me. It makes me feel good. I love it. Makes me happy again. So condensed milk. What the heck is with the story time, child? We got butter. Well, listen, okay, so normally I get the, oh yeah, I didn't mean to do that. Okay, normally I just get this butter, the stick butter, right? But the stick butter I keep in the refrigerator, it's hard. Like, I like to keep my refrigerator cold because I like my fruits cold when I eat them, and then I like my beverages cold. So everything else got to suffer, including the butter. So it gets really hard, and sometimes it's hard to spread. So I was like, I need to get me a regular butter for spreading, and then I can use this for my cooking and my baking or whatever. So then I got this butter, which this brand, I ain't never bought this brand before. Why am I talking like that? Is that really how I talk? Y'all, I'm a little up in the clouds, if you can catch my drift. So excuse all of that. Anyways, I got this brand of butter. I've never tried it before, but they say European, France, whatever. I was like, okay, well, when I was in Paris and I had butter on my toast, not my toast, my croissants and my baguettes, I like it. So, and all this is pasteurized cream, salt, and cultures, which is bacteria, gut health stuff, you know. And then I got these mini tortillas. These are actually really, really bad for you, like really bad for you, and goes against everything I freaking like talk about. Well, kind of, sort of, because I also talk about balance. Anyways, I just need to freaking make my own, because I've seen recipes on it and they're not freaking hard. Maybe on Vlogmas, I'm so excited, on Vlogmas we can make tortilla flour thingies together. Yes, because it's really not supposed to be hard, child. I'd be up in here baking cookies and biscuits and apple crisp and all these brownies, all these desserts. I can make some goddamn tortillas, okay? And why I felt the need to tell you guys that. I meant to get eggs and I think I got everything that I needed from Walmart. The only thing that I didn't get was eggs, because they literally were sold out of my eggs. And I'm like, bro, ain't nobody else in my very Caribbean friendly neighborhood buying all the eggs. Not the eggs that I buy, not the $6 eggs that I buy. So what happened to the eggs? They had one, and I was rolling my cart over like, oh, are we gonna get lucky? And I was like, I bet you they all cracked up. Not only were they all cracked the hell up, child, they had white eggs in it. I said, we don't do processed ass eggs, bro. Get your white ass egg out of here. That sounds real racist. Anyways, starting with the farmer's market. My blueberries fell out of my bag. But I got blueberries, even though it's not blueberry season. I have discovered that I like to cook my oatmeal, and we'll do it through Vlogmas. I cook my oatmeal, right, in almond milk, brown sugar, and blueberries. That's it, and it tastes so motherfucking good. I got me some romaine lettuce, also another vegetable that's not grown with GMOs, but I feel like if I'm going to eat the skin, like the entire thing, I'm gonna buy it organic. Cilantro, organic. Tomato, organic. Onion, this is not organic, but they don't grow onions with GMOs. Pomegranate, this is not organic, but they don't grow them with GMOs. Cantaloupe, not organic, but they don't grow it with GMOs. One big ass organic carrot that me and Marley are going to split. A portobello mushroom. And look, y'all, it's in a bag. It's in a freaking bag, which I hate. And it probably won't get recycled. So I'm gonna cut it up. So at least if it does end up in the ocean, it won't be like suffocating some goddamn turtle. A broccoli. We're doing roasted veggies for dinner tomorrow. I got me 2 pounds of shrimp with the tails on. thought I seen to a lizard. I got PTSD. Okay, so then I got me, I was a vegan, right? I was never a meat eating type of girl. Now I'm a pescatarian, a sustainable pescatarian, which means I buy my fish wild caught from farmers markets, not big chain grocery stores. I got fish. And this is, oh, that scared me. This is red eye snapper fillet. It's wild caught, I made sure. So this is what it looked like. And again, we're gonna be cooking this up this week, obviously. Anyway, so yeah, I got the two little fillets, okay? Hopefully we like it. But red pepper, green pepper, babe. I got me 5 little key limes from my Taco Tuesday that we're gonna try to have. Here we go. 5 little key limes. And then I also got me a organic cabbage and scallion or green onion, depending on where you're from.
Y'all, this one I got for $70. I guess that makes sense considering the seafood was $40.
Okay, let me put this stuff away and I'ma holla at y'all. Sit backwards. We have matching pajamas. Yay! So, hey friends. Anyways, we're just gonna put up Christmas decorations and bake some cookies. So, yeah. So me and Marley, we have on our matching pajamas. And the baby, they're so cute. Let me see, cause she is comfortable right now. Let's see if we can drop the camera so you can. They got Grinch on them. Cause we get Grinch. We understand Mr. Grinch. So I got these at Walmart like 2 weeks ago, I think. And the doggy one, she's a medium. The doggy one was like $14.97 or something like that. And then the adult woman's one was, I think it's like $20, something like that. But yeah, mamas, do you want to show the people's the pajamas? Let's show the people's the pajamas. Let's show the people's the pajamas, mamas. Let's show the people's. And this is mine. Can you see it? So yeah, so cute. Got the little Grinch man, and they're soft too. Come here, mama. Come here. Hi, mamas. Hi, the baby. And the put up Christmas decorations. And the put up the Christmas decorations. And the put up the Christmas decorations. Alright. Okay, so it was like, I don't know how long ago it was. My cousins came over to help me with a lizard that got into my, well, the lizard got into my house. I already killed the lizard, but they were helping me like patch up the like entry point in like my door and the back part of my house. anyways, help me patch that up or whatever. So then while they were here, I had them just help me take out the Christmas decor from my garage. I don't know if you can see it, but it's over there. So I'm gonna go ahead and hold on. First, I'm gonna take my butter and put it in my boobs because we're gonna make some cookies and we need the butter softened. So chef's tip or trick or whatever is to put it in your body for like, I think they say 30 minutes. I don't know. And then it'll help it to come room temperature. You don't wanna melt the butter. You just want it to be room temperature for cookies to get. It makes a difference, okay? It's the science behind it. It makes a difference. Baking is a science, okay? So yeah, so we got that. So it looks a little funny, but whatever, it's that. And then actually I'm gonna put it. No, yeah, I'm gonna put it like that, how I had it, yeah. Yeah, it just looks so funny. Maybe I could put it in between my chest because I got big boobs. Yeah, there we go. That's even better. The paper is like poking me. Okay, nah, I can get jiggy with that. Okay. So yeah, let's go put up these Christmas decorations.
These are all the decorations. Those bins have stuff in them. And then this is my tree. So yeah, let's go ahead and get started.
Merry Christmas, everyone. Oh, oh, oh.
Last Christmas, I gave you my heart, but the very next day, you gave it away. This year, to save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special.
Are you scared of the Christmas tree? Look at this. Look at this girl. She's like sitting in her room like being weird. What, like what's happening? Man. Are you okay?
It's like she's being a bitch about the whole situation. So you're
Marley, you okay?
Yeah. I hate her with a passion. She would send a mother to jail and have her child taken away.
This is a sweet baby. Look, her pajamas don't even fit. Oh my gosh. We just gotta get some pictures in this outfit and you don't gotta wear it no more. We'll donate it. Okay? Yeah.
I'm gonna look into getting a restraining order against Jessica so she can't pull charges on me again for no reason.
That's what you need to do.
It's just I've been having friggin' nightmares about
this. Janelle is a mess. I don't know how she get these cute white boys because this girl is a mess. Anyways, let's get back to it. Butter is nice and softened. So I'm just going to lay it on. I'm gonna put it in a bowl just to let it further soften before we get to baking because it's starting to melt. It's because I'm hot, baby. I'm hot.
Christmas,
Okay, so this is what we're working with. We can put up the rest of the Christmas decor. Yay!
While I watch Teen Mom 2.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. I don't care about the presents underneath the Christmas tree. I just want you for my own, more than you could ever know. Make my wish come true.
Practice safer sex to reduce your anxiety.